not on the Mayan world, because there are buildings that will have 5 times the size of this one, 5 times bigger, higher than this one. Real monsters able to fight with the pyramids of Egypt. Now, take a look. Looks like a pyramid, right? Usually the people have the idea that this is a pyramid, but it's not a pyramid. Get closer to the conversation. When you visit a new country or a new civilization like the Mayas, you'll try to understand the things with your background. It's okay, but at the end of the day, it's wrong. If you really want to understand the meaning of the things, you'll have to ask to the locals, to the people that build and design this place. If you ask to the Mayas, amigo, what is that? The Mayas will say, wits. Come and repeat, wits. Wits from the Mayan language. No matter which country you are, Mexico, Guatemala, no matter which Mayan city, Chichen Itza, Mayapan, Calakmul, the name of the building will be exactly the same. Wits, 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 wits. What is the translation? Mountain. Mountain. For the Mayas, this building is an artificial mountain. Why? The Mayas didn't appear from the day to the night. Before to the Mayas were other civilizations that we could name Proto-Mayas. Before to the Mayas, we have the Olmec Hokayas with more than 5,000 years old. On those civilizations, they worship the mountains. It's a symbol of life because we will provide food, animals, plants, water, everything. Those two civilizations, Hokayas and Olmecs, make a fusion, transforming the Mayas. They move to the south to start again. But they decide to continue with the tradition to worship the mountains. But tell me, do you have seen a mountain close to your resort? No, flat, totally flat. We are at the level, sometimes under the level of the ocean. To continue with the tradition, they build their own mountains. It's an artificial mountain to continue with the tradition of the old people. So, this is an artificial mountain. Why the Maya shape exactly as a pyramid? For two reasons. Didn't have metals, no iron. When you shape something as a pyramid, the building will be supported by itself, by its own weight, like the Egyptians were doing. And not only that, the Mayas were going to use this system on many buildings. For example, this tower. Take a look at the tower. Looks like a tower, but if you put it on the base, it's a pyramid. Why? Because it will be supported by itself, by its own weight. It's working really good. Now, there is other reason to shape the building as a pyramid. The Mayas worship the stars, and the most important star that we have is the sun. They spend their time watching and writing about what we're doing those stars. So the building is trying to imitate the sun. Sunrise, noon, sunset. When you follow the basic cycle of the sun with the line, you will get a pyramid, a triangle. Okay? Okay. Now, if you really want to understand the Mayas, we have to go very from the beginning, very deep. The first thing that you have to do is wonder two things. What they eat and how they eat. Get the answer and you'll be able to understand Mayas, Egyptians, China, any kind of civilization. So, let me know, amigos. Tell me, try it. What were eating the Mayas? Tacos?
Corn.
They eat corn, drink corn, sleep with the corn. The corn is everything for the Mayas. The corn and the chocolate were plants domesticated by the Mayas. No Mexico, no Mayas, no corn. No corn, no tacos, no nachos, no chips, no popcorn. If you like this kind of food, then you should love the Mayas. And it's the same with the chocolate. The Mayas are associated based on agriculture. They worship, depend, imitate the plants, being the corn, the most important element that they have. We have a lot of jungle, but there's no animals, no mammals, no horse, no cows, no porks. The Mayas didn't eat red fish. They eat the 70% of their alimentation was based on vegetables. Chili, squash, beans, cactus, and corn as the main one. They complement with a lot of seafood. For this reason, they will fight to control the coast to get this fish. Why the corn is the main one? Because we have a lot of jungle, but there's no fruits, there's no vegetables. The jungle is very short. We are at the level of the ocean. All this place is a platform of limestone. It's not fertile. It's full of salt and limestone. This jungle will survive because have long roots that will break the stones till reach the underground rivers. But we are talking about the underground rivers that are at 50, 30 meters under the surface. A tomato will not do that. Will die before to reach the water. So the only system to cultivate this place is cut and burn in the jungle. you'll cultivate with the ashes, beat on the stones, and the only plant I will do that is the corn, and will do it by itself. If you back on March, you'll see that all this place will be so hot that we have wildfire. Everything will be totally destroyed by the fire. After those 2 weeks, the first plant that started to grow up is the corn. Corn is the main plant on this place. So, mythology, fears, traditions, everything is based on agriculture for the Mayas. Why the Mayas are trying to imitate the cycle of the sun? Because it's necessary for the plantation. Take a look on the top. There's a room. Can you use the room? There's nothing into the room. No carvings, no paintings, no idols. The Mayans never close the door, but the explorers stole everything. The only remain is the face on the top. Can you see the face? Very damaged. It's a face with eyes and a mouth. It looks really sad. This is the remain of the face of Chak. Chak is the lord of the rain. They will go to the top to talk with Chak. Please, we need a good rain for the harvest. Rain. Why rain? I told you, it's necessary for the harvest. Everything is about harvest. One time you start to understand those concepts, you should understand, oh, then this is a mountain. Into the building should be a secret chamber, because the mountains have caves, and this one should have a cave. And yes, into the building, there is a secret room that was discovered at the year 1915 by the locals, not by the archaeologists, because for the archaeologists, was a tomb, was a solid building, but no. The access is on the north side. I will show you in a few minutes. 14 years ago, this room was open for the tourists, but we decided to close because the people that were there were painting the walls. John was here, Mary and John, Love Forever, Leave Garbage, Make Tea. So we decided to close for conservation. Today you have to see my pictures. If you could have the chance to get in, this is what you'll see inside. Into the building is sleeping this red jaguar. It's a jaguar throne. The red color is totally original. It's made from a tapulguita. On the past, the city was painted exactly with the same color. The green spots are made from jade, beautiful stones from Guatemala, the teeth from real human bones. What is the jaguar meaning? It's the sun into the underworld. The Mayas never have gods. We are polytheists. We have deities. The deities are the elements of the nature. And the Mayas don't have the idea about the good and the evil. For the Mayas, it's just the nature of the things. The sun has a good and a dark side. When you see the sunset, the sun will descend into the underworld and will transform as a jaguar. When you see the sunrise, the sun will back and will transform as an eagle. Now, the question is, why the sun have to go into the underworld? Will feed the plants from the roots from the underworld. It's the mythological way that have the Mayas to explain the process of the harvest. The sun feeding the plants from the underworld. But it's not so simple, because the underworld is ruled by Apuch, the lord of the dead. So before to feed the plants, Apuch and the sun will fight. When you see the sunrise, it's the victory of the sun. But the Mayas understand that maybe one day, the lord of the dead will kill the sun. No more sunrise and no more harvest. So the responsibility of the royalty is get into the room to talk with the sun to animate. Come on, you can do it. You have to defeat the lord of the dead. We need you. We need a good harvest. And the jaguar, the sun, will say, it's okay, but it's not free. You have to pay me with offerings. This is the reality, okay? Because they will have those experiences into this room. The jaguar will ask for offerings because it's not free. Nothing is free on the Mayan world. So offerings, flowers, food, beautiful stones, abstinence, no sex for a long time, fasting, no food for a long time, but usually those offerings were for the citizens. When you are talking with the sun, with the deity, you have to pay with something more expensive. So you'll pay with blood offerings. What kind of blood offerings? Were the Mayas going to roll human heads on the steps, like in the movie Apocalypse? This is just Mel Gibson and his big imagination, because they never did that. No, the royalty will make something better. They will get into the room, they will take a seat on the jaguar, the king, the queen, the priest. They will practice the immolation. They will mutilate their body with a knife made from beautiful stones like the obsidian, for their face, shoulders, breast. For this reason, on the recreations, you'll see them with all those scars on their body, because are the scars of the rituals. They will get a stingray fishbone, a very big needle, and the queen will have piercing her tongue. She will pass through the wound, a cotton string to absorb the blood. The king and the priest will pierce penis, testicles, genitals in general, and they fill the wounds with cotton. The cotton will absorb the blood, and at the end will be born. This is blood. Yeah. Would you like to try with me?
You go first.